Hello YouTube, I'm here with another Road to Legendary Hearthstone series. The ladder reset was a few days ago, so I didn't have that much time to play, but it should be fine. I'm gonna use mostly the Druid deck to climb a bit higher. Then I'll probably switch to Miracle, maybe some Shaman, Mage, or just keep playing Druid. But I choose Druid because it has a fair matchup against most classes. If you're new to Hearthstone, or if you are like tryhard mode activated and you wanna climb really fast, you should play Zoo, because they are really fast games. You can get like a lot of win streaks and you'll climb really fast, and then you can switch when you get to like rank 5 or 4, switch to another standard deck. But Zoo it's just boring to me, and I can't really stand playing it. You don't change your playstyle, like every game you do the same thing. I'm just gonna show you the Druid deck right here. It's a pretty standard Druid deck. It's not like a ramp Druid with high creatures. It's more like a mid-range classic old Druid with some Watchers in it, because they are really good against aggro. So I'm just gonna go like Innervate and Wild Growth are no-brainers, really good cards. Mark of the Wild has a really good synergy with Ancient of Watcher and Big Game Hunter. You can kill like a 5 attack creature, Mark of the Wild, and Big Game Hunter. Unfortunately, I don't have a Black Knight yet, so I would definitely use a Black Knight in this deck, but I don't have it. If you have one, you should use it. Yeah, but it's really good to Mark of the Wild like any creature to give it taunt if you're like against the Rush deck. Ancient of Lore, like a really good card, can't argue about it. Ragnaros or like Cenarius or like Sierra, or like a really big late game card. I play Ragnaros because it's really good versus Freeze Mage, Miracle, and that kind of stuff. Karn is like a bit slow, but it's really good. I only play one Force of Nature and Savager combo, and the rest of the cards are pretty much like good card in general. Nothing to say about that. I play two Big Game Hunters mostly because of Handlock. It's not that popular at these ranks, but you definitely could face some Handlocks because they are really good versus Miracle and Zoo, which are really popular right now. So it's like a 50-50, I guess. Now, I'm versus a Druid, and if he's like Ramp Druid, I'm pretty much in a horrible position, because he has an advantage on me, because he'll play like bigger guys faster than me, and I will have no answer. So I'll have to get like a really fast board position and finish the game faster with like a combo. I mulligan there my all hand because I wanted a Wild Growth really badly, or like an Innervate to combo something out. There's no point to keep the Harvest Golem. It's like a bit not slow, but you'll eventually get it. I'm just gonna Sun Fury here to get some pressure in. Again, if he is like Ramp Druid, which I think he is, I will have a really hard time, and it will be really hard to win this game. So I'm trying to put as much pressure as I can. Although, yeah, Wild Growth is pretty standard, but he's probably like... Actually, I'm not sure. Okay. I'm just gonna go face here, since there's no favorable trade for me. If he will attack into this, then I can hero power and do something else, or I don't know. But he can't really swipe anything, so there's no reason for me to... Yeah, the swipe does basically nothing. He will just kill an Yeti, but he used coin and the hero power, so I guess I'm fine. He will trade one of these. Okay, that's fine. There's not really a reason why you should kill this, because if I'm just gonna hero power and kill this, there will still be a token left that's the same value to one. So, and I will have no play. I'll have to do something like really stupid. That's not unfortunate for me, but it's really like interesting that he had to swipe that fast. But it's fine. If I get a good card right here to play, like another Druid of the Claw or an E80 or something like that, yeah, that's really good. Like the E80, I think it was the best top deck right here. Because the Ancient of Watchers are like dead cards in a control versus control matchup, unless you can use the silence on them. But at the same time, the silence is really valuable in the to kill your opponent stuff like this. I mean, that was my point. If he plays like something big like this, it's really hard for me to do anything. So I have to swipe this, I guess. Like swipe is 4 and then that's shit. I can swipe it and hope that he's not having another one. He can also play something like another Ancient of Lore or something. Now, if he has something like Farseer, I'm fucked.
Time waits for no one.
If he has something like Farseer here, I'm pretty dead. Or if he enchants of Lord to heal this. Basically, I'm just waiting for another more minions. So yeah, that's fine. I can be GH that. Basically, I was waiting for something more out of him because I just wanna have answers to it. Now I can do this, and I can like swipe this. And next turn I will be able to silence this, or just like silence another Ancient of War. If he goes like Ancient of Lore, I can ref this for 1. That's interesting. Double ref, okay. I wouldn't draw that much if I was him, because if I have like a Savage Fury in my hand, and I get what is called? The force of nature, and you do something like that aggressive and not keeping your ref, like ref for 3 and do something else. But I guess it was fine because he spent his mana right and he has more options now. How do I get rid of this? There's no real way, to be honest. I could like silence this attack and then attack with my face.
I must safeguard the land.
Like the Ancient of War, the Ancient Watcher won't get any more value than this. But yeah, like I said, if he plays like another, like a scenario, here would be really bad. What else? Any big creature in general, and he has them. I don't. Also, I had like two dead cards in my hand. There was no reason to play Wild Growth because I overflowed mana like every turn. So okay, so I guess I'm not in a horrible spot, but he has like the cards over me. So I really need an Ancient of oh my god. Ancient of Lore. Great draw. There's no need to wild growth first, because I'll probably not get a better answer. I'm gonna wild growth here and use this. Really hoping for a force of nature, to be honest. I could innervate and use a Sunfury Protector, and I think I will do that. Just because of board pressure and the possibility of getting force of nature. I will have one more body to Savage Roar. And he used both swipes, so I'm not worried about board clears. Also, like in this stage of the game, like every creature counts. So if we trade like this and this stays to one health, it's fine. Farseer would be really good right here. Ancient of Lore. Oh my god, Ancient of Lore here. Okay. I'm like, what? Harvest Golem or what? Mark of the Wild. Be ancient. Okay. I would have just Mark of the Wild this. Just because I've seen my opponent using a Big Game Hunter, so he might have another one. But this is like an amazing top deck right here, so I'm just gonna Wild Grow first. Just to see what I get. Okay, Ancient of Lore. So I'm just gonna rag because it has like two great targets to kill. So this, even if this gets BGH'd or something, I have like a high chance to kill, yeah, kill him or like kill two really big creatures. So the rag was an insane top deck right there. At in the base case scenario, I just win the game. But even if I don't win the game, it's like I kill a 7/7 or the 4/7. It's really good. I was really fortunate with the last two top decks, the Ancient of Lore and the Rag. It was basically the best cards that I could get right there. He took like really a lot of damage early, and he used Ancient of Lore to heal the Druid of the Clone instead of himself. You have to be careful about that because you may never know when you get comboed by the Druid or you get comboed by the Druid or just die to minions. I just mulliganed the whole hand there because I have two Ancients of Lore, which they are the great cards, but they are really high on curve, so I can't use them. And the other cards are like decent, but I could get better, so my hand is a lot better than it used to be. I'm just gonna coin some fury here to put some pressure on. There's no reason why not to do this, because if you use Rock Bitter, it's fine. It's like trading a card for a card, and with one mana he won't be able to play anything else. This will trade really good with totems, and at the same time I would never coin this if I don't have another 2-drop to play. So if he also like lightning bolt this, he will get overloaded, won't be able to play like any 3-drop, which is fine again because I'm just gonna Sun Fury Protector again and he will totem. Or nothing more than totem, I should say. And it's pressure that you can use with this deck. It's really fine if you have a good curve like this. Like Sun Fury into Sun Fury into Harvest into Keeper. That's really great. Having like an EAT to play on turn 4, it's amazing again. I should also consider like running double Azure Drake instead of Watchers. But if I play double Azure Drake instead of Watchers, I should also remove the Sun Fury Protectors. That makes sense. This deck is more suitable against aggro rather than control matchups, just because you'll have like some dead cards. But since I'm like a really low rank, I mean high but low rank, 13, there's a higher chance to get faced against aggro decks rather than control decks, even though my last games are against control decks. And this deck is fine against them, but it's not insane. Because if the Shaman manages somehow to clear my board and we're like just even, his hero power will like outmatch my hero power. Shaman is like a 60 to 40 against Druid in my opinion, but it really depends on the draws, to be honest. It's not like Handlock versus Miracle, where it doesn't really matter what the Handlock draws unless it's like a terrible hand. Yeah, so he would like totem again and probably pass or like lightning bolt this or silence this, but there's no reason to silence this right now. I would really love to get a Yeti right here. Another Harvest Golem is fine. The other options were to Keeper of the Grove kill that, but Keeper of the Grove, it's not a great card for the for board control. Like Harvest Golem is pretty much the same thing, maybe even better against Shaman. Rev for one damage and hero power was a viable option, but I would love to keep the Rev for something big that he will play on turn 4. To go like Rev hero power or Rev and send the Golem in. Like this. And have like a free Karn on turn 6. I'm just gonna ref one of them, send the Golem in, send my hero power and just go one more in base. Usually I'd be a bit scared to play Karn on turn 6, but I wouldn't mind if he gets hexed right away because I have a turn 8 play in Ragnaros. The odds of him of having two hexes are actually, I don't know, he could have like some cards that are like Flame Tongue and hexes in his hand because he's taking a lot of time to think what he will do on turn 4, which is awkward because at least he will have like an Unbound Elemental to play or an Yeti or something. So I guess he has like a really high curve. Fire Elemental next turn probably, or okay, so he used the Stoneforge Axe, so he'll be able to play the Fire Elemental next turn, so I need to be careful about that. But if he plays like Fire Elemental, he will not have mana to play anything else, so it's fine to Karn, to go Karn right here, because if you use Fire Elemental to kill this and go face into this, this will be like an untouched, unharmed. He can't even Earth Shock, so I'll be able to trade with the Fire Elemental and hit my face or just go swipe or something like that or Keeper of Grove. So it's still fine. You should really count every time how much mana the Shaman has, and count like 6 mana is like a big Fire Elemental. You should always watch for Lightning Storm. I think he's thinking like, should I hex this? Or go Fire Elemental and kill one of the columns. He went double Feral Spirits, that's interesting. That's actually really interesting, I wasn't expecting that. Yeah, like I said, he had a Flame Tongue. So, these cards are probably another Flame Tongue or something, like a Big Game Hunter. Really situational cards that are not really good. Swap is not bad here. Swap is actually fine because I'll be able to kill this. Sure, kill this I guess, and like hit this and I could Mark of the Wild this. So he won't die, it won't die to Stoneforge Axe. I might just as well do that. Because if he had like a silence, he would play the last turn on like any creature of my any creature of either Karn or Harvest Golem. But since he didn't played it, it means that he doesn't have it. So I can easily Mark of the Wild this. You shouldn't go all in and have Mark of the Wild this, because if he gets like a hex or like a silence, it's not like he will nullify the death rattle of the card. He will also kill the buff that you just put on the creature. So it's like no reason to do that. I was a bit fortunate to get to not get any of my creatures killed, but at the same time, even if I got like 3 damage, they will respawn, so not a huge deal there. I could go aggressive and just go face, put a rag down, hope to hit his face, and finish with a force of nature, right? Or like... I think that's right. Oh my god, and I also got the innervate so I can kill the Searing Totem. That innervate was really good. One second, let me lower this. So now he's on 3 health. It's really hard for him to win this game. To be honest, it was decided like from the beginning. He had no answers to my aggressive start. And I think I don't know why he might got like really unlucky, because he has like some cards that he didn't even play, and it's turn 9. So he might have something, some dead cards like Flame Tongue or... to be honest, I don't even know. Maybe a rag, but yet again, rag is not that common. Maybe Elekir or Wind Fury. But yeah. In this matchup is really... It's really all about board control. Even more than the other control matchups, because if you just let the shaman get all the totems, he will have the taunt that you'll have to get past every turn. He will have the spell power increase, which is huge because he has lots of spells, and basically you give him the freedom to react however he wants. If you put the pressure first and kill totems and just put pressure on him, you should be fine. Now this matchup, if he's face, I should be fine in theory, but I'm not sure. I'm just gonna keep Mark of the Wild because it's fine on any creature. And I'm gonna keep Rav because if it's mid-range hunter and he will play the Croc on turn 2, then I have to kill that because it will just get Houndmaster. The next turn, so yeah. I also got an Ancient of Watcher, so I'm really happy I kept Mark of the Wild. Now, if it's a mid-range hunter, he'll go like Croc, River Croc right here. Knife Juggler, interesting. That's also a really good target to Rav. Next turn I can Ancient of Watcher, Sunfury Protector, which I think is better than Mark of the Wild. If you go like Ancient of Watcher, Mark of the Wild, you're really vulnerable to Hunter's Mark. You shouldn't put like all eggs in one basket. I can also just Ancient Watcher, but since I have the feeling this is a really aggressive deck, I might as well just coin the Sunfury now, even though it buffs only one target. The other option to do was like just Ancient of Watcher, but this doing this, I won't take any damage from like a Wolf Rider or something like that, or like a Misha, Huffer, I mean. So this Huffer is like not doing anything; he's not even killing this. So I'm really glad I played the taunt. On paper, this druid is actually really good versus the... So he chose not to attack, which I think it might be a mistake, but at the same time, doing this tells me that he wants me to trade like this, which means that we'd leave this card open to a BGH. To a BGH, I mean to a deadly shot. So if I'm gonna go trade this and not play any creature, this will get BG8, which is awful. So I could go Big Game Hunter. There's like no creature on the... Yeah, I'm gonna go BGH. I can go BGH of, or Mark of the Wild this and save it with 1 HP, which might be okay. No, I'm just gonna go BGH. Yeah, I'm gonna go BGH. Basically, I'm really scared of Deadly Shot. So I just wanna have like 50-50 chance to kill the... to save the Ancient Watcher. Also, this way I save a Taunt Giver. That will... the Sunfury Protector would have like 1 health, which is not great. Yeah, so I'm just gonna Mark of the Wild this. And push for pressure. Basically, if he wants to trade like this, I can just hero power this. If he wants to go this, this will just die. Also, I put more pressure on him like this. And it's not really a difference if it if he has 2 HP or from 2 to 5, because it will die to kill command anyway. So yeah, like this, I will force him to use a kill command on something. Probably kill command this and trade this. Which means that next turn I will have to hero power. And like 4 drop or a harvest golem would be really good. A Yeti or a harvest golem. Or something under 4 mana. Like 4 mana or less, so I can play. Because my turn 6 is really obvious, I'll just Ancient of Lore. Even turn 8 is pretty obvious. Because Drag is really good versus versus Hunter. Interesting. This might be misdirection, so I'll probably not attack face. I'll just keep the taunt. It looks like misdirection, to be honest. Well, why else would he? Oh, actually, it could be Freezing Trap also. So I'm just gonna trade this and play my Harvest Golem. There's no need to attack. It's probably Freezing Trap, like the way he played it. So there's no need to attack with the Big Game Hunter, I can just keep it. It's a taunt, so it's fine. Now, I would love to get a Keeper of the Grove or the Savannah High main. Because even though it looks one-sided, I don't have a board at the moment. Basically, that's most likely Freezing Trap, so I just have one creature on board. If you play something like Savannah High Main, it might get a little bit, I don't know. It's nice that I get I have an Ancient of Lore to play on turn 6 to draw cards and keep another one to heal myself if shit goes bad. That Daily Shot was really fortunate for me, to be honest. If he's not gonna kill this in any way, then I can proc the trap with it, which is really nice. If he's gonna kill this, then it's most likely a Freezing Trap. Okay, so I will try to trade this. Wait, I'm gonna Ancient of Watcher. No, let's see. This might... Wait. Can I draw... Even if I get a Wrath, I won't be able to use it on the Fairy Dragon. So there's no reason to Ancient of Lore first. Right? Yeah, no reason. So I'll try to trade this. If it's Freezing Trap, it's fine. It's probably Freezing Trap. Yeah, it's Freezing Trap. Obviously. Yay, I got the damage golem. Awesome. That I'll probably never play. So now I'm just gonna go and Danger on the Floor, right? The other play is to go Rag. If I go Rag, if it hits Hay face, that's actually a lot of damage, to be honest. I'm gonna attack face here anyway because I wanna put some pressure. And I might just drag here to be honest. Actually no, I'm gonna ancient the blow. Let's ancient the blow. Another innervate, wow. Double innervate. That's really good I guess. Now Rag could kill like this or just go face. If I had like Savage Roar on the board, I mean in my hand, I would definitely go Rag. But like this, it's fine, decent. If he Hunter's Mark this, it's really good because then Rag would be really hard to get rid of. He will get like tons of cards, which means he will most likely get the Hunter's Mark right here. Probably do this, Hunter's Mark this, and keep the Starving Buzzard and the two doggies out. If he doesn't have Hunter's Mark though, I mean like in a really good spot. Like really really good spot. Like a really good spot. And he does not have a Hunter's Mark, so it's fine. Since I'm not gonna be able to kill, like, even if I kill a doggy, there's still a high chance that I hit another doggy with the rag, so I'll miss 5 damage. But like this, if I get a Savage Roar, then I can kill the Hunter with the combo. So, if I don't go 5 damage face, I won't be able to kill with the combo, and I will just rely on rag to get a lucky hit on him. So the health, even if it was lower, there's like no difference for me. Yeah, that's fine. That's his second deadly shot, so... It's really unfortunate for him that he didn't draw like any Hunter's Mark. If he's not playing Hunter's Mark, then it might be a mistake because I can't really see a Hunter deck without Hunter's Mark. I would really love a swipe here though. Okay, so he's gonna go face I guess? Oh wow, that's brave. That's really brave. That usually means that he has double kill command in his hand. If he does something like that. So I might just heal myself right here, right? Let's see. That's actually really interesting. Because if he has double kill command, then I'll take how much damage? 10 from kill commands and another 2 from the hero power. So that's 12. So the Ancient of Lore will actually save me. And there's no point to taunt. So wow, no swipe has been seen that day. I can also like Force of Nature, but I guess that's Force of Nature, right? What am I talking about? I just win this game, right? Oh my god, I'm so stupid. 7... How much is this? Yeah, I just win the game. Oh my god, I'm so blind. Jesus. I almost missed little. So fucking bad. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I'm looking forward to your comments. I really want to improve my commentary, and I can only do that with your help, so make sure you comment and tell me what you like and what you don't like about the series so far. I will upload like 2 or even 3 videos every day, so if you're interested in the climbing the ladder or the series itself, make sure you subscribe or just check my channel from time to time. Thank you again for watching, and talk to you in the comments. Have a good day, guys.